This episode of DNews is brought to you by the Toyota Corolla. Let's lead the way.
They are everywhere in every city. They're pooping on our statues and ledges. They're eating trash. They're annoying rats with wings. They're squabs and sky rats are just, ugh, get out of my way, bird. Hey everyone, thank you for watching DNews. I'm Trace. I'm gonna ruin every pretty bird releasing ceremony that you've ever seen, because they are releasing sky rats. Pigeons are part of the family Columbidae, and within it, there are over 300 species, including both pigeons and doves, because the names are used interchangeably. These birds are so successful that they have spread across the entire planet, except the Sahara, Antarctic, and High Arctic. The first mention of pigeons appeared in Mesopotamia. Ancient humans eventually domesticated them and kept them for food, just like the chicken. Because of their monogamy and two-parent family units, the dove and the pigeon were used in religious ceremonies, and later to represent deities like Ishtar, Venus, the Holy Spirit, or Aphrodite. Once they'd been domesticated, we learned that homing pigeons could be used in bird races or to carry messages. Europeans brought the rock pigeon with them to North America, where it interbred with the native pigeon and started to spread everywhere. That native was the famous passenger pigeon. They were likely the most numerous bird in the world in the 1800s, with 136 million breeding adults in one site in Wisconsin alone, adding up to billions if you think of the whole country. Accounts by Native Americans and European naturalists both say that the sky could turn dark for hours while these birds migrated overhead. Of course, now the passengers are all extinct from our hunting and feeding practices. Hey, humans! The rock pigeon we still see in our cities today carries some of this passenger pigeon DNA, but it's mainly a feral mix of the original rock pigeon variety. These birds are still good for racing and for speed. They're adept flyers and evade predators even in New York City, which is why you rarely see dead ones. Yeah, stray cats get them, but so do owls, falcons, hawks, things that live in Midwestern and Eastern cities. They're looking for those tasty, juicy birds, which breed year-round. Even humans eat them. If you see squab on a menu, that's pigeon, friends. So after learning all about them, I now want to put pigeons forth as a super bird. These things are crazy cool. For example, pigeon navigation. It is not well understood, but a 2013 paper in the Journal of Experimental Biology posits that it has to do with infrasound, or extreme low-frequency sound waves generated by the ocean and reverberating through our planet. Using these pervasive sounds, the researchers believe pigeons can make a mental map of their surroundings and find their way home. And this month, a new study in the Proceedings of the National Academy of Sciences explored this super bird, finding that their flying is some of the best in the world. They're acrobatic, they can avoid cars and predators, and when captured with high-speed cameras, they found the simple pigeon could hold their wings up to slide through small spaces, or they can tuck them in to barrel through spots and protect their body in case of a miscalculation and crash. During his research into the origin of species, Darwin studied and bred pigeons, exploring their variations and adaptations through selective breeding. Today, researchers at the University of Utah are doing the same thing, but with genome sequencing, probing how a little pigeon can contain such amazing diversity. Look at these: mourning doves, Jacobins, passenger, red capuchin, king pigeons, rock pigeons, that's the one you see in the city. These are all closely related. If we bred these like we would with dogs, we'd see amazing colors and feather patterns, and some people actually do this. Pigeons are freaking awesome. When I started researching this piece, I was seriously calling them sky rats and like kind of writing them off, but not anymore. Super birds all the way. But what do you think? Are you gonna look at these little birds differently now? You can tell us in the comments. You can subscribe for more DNews. And something else people spend a lot of time ignoring is abandoned buildings, but I love them. These neglected places aren't just ruins waiting to fall down, but pieces of our history. They're important to understanding how we got here. So in this new show, Abandonment Issues, I go explore them.
For 50 years, through two world wars, this train yard was full of steam and smoke, and the sounds of monstrous engines and metal tools. But by the end of the 1950s, steam trains were on the way out.
You can click on the link in the description to watch and subscribe. It is the first episode, but there is more to come, so tell me what you think. Thanks for watching.
This episode of DNews is brought to you by the Toyota Corolla. Let's lead the way.